Patella fractures in adults. The patella is the largest sesamoid bone that sits at the front of your knee and serves several important functions. It connects the muscles in the front of the thigh to the tibia. The quadriceps and patellar tendon attach to the patella, which normally allows you to flex and extend your knee. Patella also protects the knee joint from direct trauma. Patella fractures account for approximately 1% of all skeletal injuries in adults. A fracture may be a simple, clean, two-piece break, or the bone can break into many pieces. A break can occur at the top, center, or lower part of the bone. It's usually caused by direct injury, such as a fall onto a flexed knee or striking the dashboard during an automobile accident. Direct blunt trauma often causes comminuted fractures. In a comminuted fracture, your bone has shattered into three or more pieces. Fractures can also result from an indirect force applied to the patella through sudden forceful contraction of the quadriceps, such as landing on one's feet after jumping from a moderate height or coming to a sudden stop from a full sprint. Indirect trauma most commonly causes a transverse fracture where the patella breaks into two pieces, but it can also lead to lower pole or upper pole avulsion fractures. A kneecap fracture is considered closed if the broken pieces of patella do not pierce the skin. In an open fracture, the bone breaks in such a way that bone fragments stick out through the skin, or a wound penetrates down to the bone. Fracture may be either displaced or non-displaced. In non-displaced fracture, the pieces of bone may remain in contact with each other, or be separated by just a millimeter or two. In a displaced fracture, the broken ends of the bone are separated and do not line up correctly. The normally smooth joint surface may have also moved. Patella fractures are classified as displaced if there is greater than 2 millimeters of articular step-off, or 3 millimeters of separation of the fracture fragments. A hairline kneecap fracture is a simple crack in the bone where the patella is still in one piece. Hairline fractures are also known as stress fractures and are rare in the kneecap. They can occur in athletes, such as marathon runners, and may be due to overuse. Vertical fractures are much less common than either transverse or comminuted fractures and can be produced by both indirect and direct forces. Diagnosis. Patella fracture should be considered when a patient presents with an acutely swollen knee and patella pain following direct or indirect trauma. Examination typically reveals a joint effusion and focal tenderness of the patella. The patient may not be able to extend the knee against gravity, and a gap in the extensor mechanism may be palpable. Overlying lacerations and abrasions are often present when the mechanism of injury involves a fall onto the knee. It is most important that the doctor carefully assess the function of the extensor mechanism and look for any open fracture. Examination of the knee extensor mechanism is important because disruption requires surgical repair. Intra-articular injection of analgesic may be necessary to determine whether inability to extend the knee is due to pain rather than disruption of the extensor mechanism. The knee extensor mechanism can be assessed by having the patient bend the knee either by allowing the injured leg to dangle over the side of the examination table, or by placing towels under the injured knee and then having the patient gently extend the knee against gravity. The doctor must carefully assess the femur, hip and pelvis for injury if the fracture results from high-energy blunt trauma such as a motor vehicle accident. A patella fracture is diagnosed by X-ray. Standard radiographic evaluation includes anteroposterior, lateral, and sunrise views. If distal pole comminution, patellar stress fracture or other injuries are suspected, a CT scan may be done. Treatment. In case of intact extensor mechanism, non-displaced or minimally displaced fractures, or vertical fracture patterns, non-operative managements are indicated. Also, patients who are debilitated, poor surgical candidates for other reasons, or who have poor bone quality are often managed non-operatively. Non-surgical treatment includes knee immobilization with a cylinder cast from the groin to the ankle, ending just proximal to the malleoli, with the knee in extension, not hyperextension, with full weight bearing for 4 to 6 weeks. The cast is generally placed 5 to 7 days following injury to allow swelling to subside. Follow-up radiographs should be taken 2 weeks after the injury, to ensure the fracture remains non-displaced, and again 4 to 6 weeks after the injury. After cast removal, patients begin rehabilitation with knee range of motion exercises. Gradually, strengthening exercises are added to the regimen. Surgical treatment. Referral for operative repair is recommended in the following circumstances. Disruption of the extensor mechanism, unable to perform straight leg raise. Open fractures. Fractures with greater than 2 mm of articular step-off. Fractures with greater than 3 mm of fragment separation. Loose bodies. The goal of operative repair is rigid bone fixation that allows for early joint motion and rehabilitation. Restoration of articular congruity to minimize the risk of degenerative arthritis and ultimately restoration of function. The surgeon will attempt to preserve and reattach as much of the patella as possible. If the fracture has not been opened, the doctor may recommend waiting until any abrasions have healed before having surgery. If the fracture was open, however, there is an increased risk of infection and immediate treatment is required to prevent infection. Two-part fractures are most often fixed in place using screws or pins and wires and a figure of 8 configuration tension band. The figure of 8 band presses the two pieces together. If the kneecap is broken in many pieces and the pieces are separated, the doctor may use a combination of wires and screws to fix it. Another approach to a transverse fracture is to secure the bones using small screws or small screws and small plates. When the bone fragments at the ends of the patella are too small to be fixed back into place, the doctor will remove them. He will then attach the loose patellar tendon back to the remaining patellar bone. Complete removal of the kneecap is a last resort in treating a comminuted fracture. Post-surgery. The knee will be immobilized with a cylinder cast from the groin to the ankle, ending just proximal to the malleoli, with the knee in extension, not hyperextension, with full weight bearing for 4 to 6 weeks. Complete healing requires 8 to 10 weeks. After cast removal, patients begin rehabilitation with knee range of motion exercises. Gradually, strengthening exercises are added to the regimen. Depending on your age and health, it takes about 3 to 6 months to recover from a broken patella. Most people will be able to return to all of their normal activities, but very severe patellar injuries may take longer. Sometimes, especially in patients who are thin, the wires, pins or screws can be irritating. In this case, the devices will be removed after the patella has fully healed.